Hi. For big complicated calculations on a scientific calculator like this TI-30X, it is possible to do it all in one calculation, but I don't recommend that. I recommend doing one piece at a time according to the rules of order of operations. So one piece at a time, according to order of operations, which most of us know as PEMDAS. Right, I also want to introduce the previous answer feature on almost all scientific calculators. This feature allows me to get an answer and compute on from there. So for a quick example, let's say that I want 6 times 7 plus 8. Then PEMDAS says I should multiply before adding. I could do the whole thing in one calculation, but I'm going to do it one piece at a time according to order of operations. I'm going to take 6 times 7 and I hit equal. 6 times 7 equals 42. I'm not writing it down and I'm going to add 8 to it without re-entering the number 42. I leave the number 42 on the screen and I just hit plus 8. Then it shows previous answer plus 8. So this, once I get hit the equal symbol, then I have the previous answer. And then I just plus 8 from there and then I hit equal. That gets me the final answer of 50. Now let's say that we have a more complicated calculations. Let's say a compound interest formula, 1000 times 1 plus 0.035 divided by 365 raised to the power of 4 times 365. There's an implied grouping symbol here because all of the exponent should be one number. According to the rules of PEMDAS, I need to do these two grouping symbols first before I raise to the power, and then the multiplication will go after that. Between these two grouping symbols, I'm going to choose to do this grouping symbol first. I'm going to do this second. So the raise to power is third and the multiplication is fourth. I choose to do the exponent first because, as you will see, it's more natural in the sequence of using the previous answer feature, but also because the exponent is a nice integer. So let's do that. So 4 times 365 equals 1460. So for this one, I do need to write down the number 1460. Now, I'm going to start with the base. The base has two pieces. It has a fraction, a division, and an addition. Well, according to the rules of PEMDAS, division comes before addition. So I divide first. So I go 0.035 divided by 365 equals. I get a decimal number, which I won't write down. I know that it's this fraction here, so I'm just going to add 1 on top of that. So I leave it as is, and I hit plus 1. Then the screen will show previous answer plus 1. I hit equal. I get a long decimal, which is all of these parentheses. All of this grouping symbol is this long decimal. I need to take it to the power 1460. So I'm just going to leave it on the screen. I hit raise to power. Now, about the raise to power button. Different calculators may have it differently. It may look like a caret. It may look like x to the y or y to the x, depending on the model. And it may also look like x to a black box. So any of these could be the exponent key on your calculator. On this one, it is the caret symbol right here. I'm here at this base. I have this base as the decimal, so I'm going to take this decimal. I raise to power 1460. So I hit the caret. Caret 1460. So it's the base raised to power 1460 equals. Again, I get a big long decimal, which is all of this now. All I need to do is multiply by 1000. So again, I leave it on the screen. I go times 1,000 equals. And that's my answer. And because it's about American money, I round to nearest penny. So the answer is 1150.27. All right, next example. This example shows what happens if the previous answer is actually on the second part of the big long calculation, and so it doesn't lend itself easily to just piling another computation on top of it. Now let's take this monthly payment formula. So let's say 175 divided by all of 1 minus parentheses 1 plus 0.06 divided by 12 to the power negative 12 times 15. So again, there is an implied grouping symbol here. These two grouping symbols will go first, followed by the exponential, followed by the 1 minus, and then this division will go last because there's a big implied grouping symbol for all of the denominator also. All right, so again, because this is one number and it's a simple calculation and it's a nice integer, I'm going to do this first. I'm going to do this second. The power will be third. The subtraction will be fourth. And the division will be fifth. All right, so first, negative 12 times 15. Important, on a graphing calculator, the negative key and the subtraction key are two separate keys. So this key is most commonly in this form, is a negative key. I also have seen it in this symbol, kind of like a sign change symbol. Positive becomes negative becomes positive. So either of them would be the negative key. Whereas this symbol, this key right here is a subtraction symbol, and it requires two numbers, one number subtracting another. Okay, so make sure you use the correct key. So right now it's the number negative 12 being multiplied by 15. So it's negative 12 times 15 equals, so this number here is negative 180. So I write it down there. Now I do it like before. This fraction comes before the adding one. So it's 0.06 divided by 12. Equals, and then I add one on top of that, plus one, equals, I get 1.005, which is all of these parentheses. So I raise to the power negative 180, raise to the power negative 180, and one more time is the negative key, not the subtraction key, equals. Right, so I have this decimal here, which is all of this part. And I need to take 1 minus that. Well, I need 1 minus the answer. So I cannot have just subtract 1 off of it because it's the wrong direction. So let me show you where this is. On many calculators that I have seen, it is above the negative key. I have also seen it above the equal sign. So just look for the ANS, and it's usually above the key. Right, so this is my current answer, which is stored in ANS. So I need 1 minus that, so I go 1 minus. And then because it's above the key, I need to use the second button. So second, that button, and it gets me 1 minus the answer. Equals 0.59, etc. So all of this is the denominator. All of this is all of the denominator. I still need 175 divided by the denominator. So I go 175 divided by the answer, which in terms of keystroke is second, and then answer above the negative key. So 175 divided by second. Answer. So on the screen it shows 175 divided by the previous answer, which is what I want. And so the final result is 295.349, which rounds to 35. All right, hope that helps.